team leader. Glad to see everybody back at Heidi Ho, Creativity and Innovation Company. So first of all, I just want to congratulate Katie on her creative idea last week on how to innovate the Skittles, making them hot dog flavored. Just a brilliant, brilliant idea. It was just.
I was surprised it worked.
Yeah, I was skeptical at first, but I mean, you know, it's summer's coming around. People like hot dogs. People like Skittles. Why not feel good?
Why not?
You know, so I bravo. Hats off to you, girl.
Three packs for dinner last night.
Yeah, it was good. Well, why I called this meeting today is because basically we have another problem. People aren't appreciating art. We have a lack of art appreciation in the community, and we really, really need to get the word out there, try to get people more interested in art. And we decided to build an art center in downtown Greensboro. But before we do that, we really need to get the community's feedback to see if this is actually going to work. So we want to ask them some questions about art appreciation, why there's a lack of art appreciation, and what type of advertising would reach out to them if we were to build an art center. So what type of methods do you think we should, what should we do to just reach out to our community and get their attention? What do you guys think?
This is something to throw out there.
Maybe at the bottom of the beer cup.
Yeah. Talented.
You can only see it when you finish.
Yeah. Artful beer. Yeah. I like that.
Beer art.
Beer art. Yeah. There we go.
Beer art.
Oh my gosh.
What?
I've got it.
What?
Guerrilla marketing.
I think I like that. What do you think, Phil?
I'm going to use real gorillas. Or?
It's G-U-E.
Oh, okay.
Not like monkeys or chickens.
Sorry.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
We could think about maybe.
I'm still new here. I'm just
okay. Yeah. All right. So, I mean, I think this is a really good way we can put all these ideas in one and hit our target market, go out there and just bombard them with questions and get a good response, especially from college students. I mean, college students always want to be up there.
I'm new here. Can you explain me what is guerrilla marketing in this case? Certain audience don't know what it is.
Well, basically a guerrilla marketing campaign is, in layman's terms, just a cheap way to do advertising without using a lot of money or glitz and glamour. So it's just a really simple way to advertise.
Get it out there.
Kind of like word of mouth.
Yeah, almost like word of mouth. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Cool.
So
I like that.
Yeah.
I like it. I
think it's going to be a great idea. So we can definitely get the word out and do what we got to do.
Well, since I work at a daycare, I kind of tend to think of finger painting right off the bat.
I think of creativity.
I think of talent.
I guess being able to visualize something and actually make that thing apparent.
Paintings, dancing, drawings.
Dancing in the street. Yeah.
Well, dancing in the streets is what you do.
Sculptures. I really, really like sculptures. I think it's cool how people can create anything that they want and make it look realistic.
Probably music is my favorite form, and that's only because it's what I'm exposed to the most.
Okay. Music, because I think music just speaks to everybody. Like, I think you can find some type of music that speaks to you, or a song or something that will describe what you're going through right then. I like drawing because I can do it. And I like dance because I can't do it, but I appreciate it. And I think the fact that these people put in so much time and effort to do what they do, I think it's really cool.
Because it makes no sense.
My least favorite form was poetry because it was something that they made us do, and I personally didn't feel that you can make somebody write a poem. You know, I really didn't have anything to talk about, and to write it in such a way to where it fits into the category of poetry, you know, I didn't feel that it was necessary.
My least favorite form of art would probably be some type of patents, just because I don't get, like, I just don't get it. Like, it's just a bunch of colors on the page, and they're like, yes, this accentuates the struggle of people through history, and I'm like, it just looks like someone dropped paint on the paper. I guess like a lot of expressionism stuff,
right?
But I don't really get.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I think it was, and I think it does, honestly, because nowadays, even toys and stuff, everything is, it comes with instructions, they're all color-coded, like, basically your toy can only be made into one thing, or so a lot of people think. And so, I mean, when I was little, we were given paper and crayons, and we did what we wanted to do, but now kids are so attached to video games, and, I mean, and, you know, like, video games and stuff are art too, but I think, like, classical type stuff gives you, it makes you work your brain more, and it's actually more helpful.
Right.
I really feel that in the downtown area, if we had one, I know we have a children's museum, maybe if we could branch it off of something like that, or put it near one of the Boys and Girls Clubs or YMCAs around campus, I mean around Greensboro, just put it in an area where there are children about. I mean, it's not just going to benefit kids, but that's where I feel like we should start off at as kids, because if they grow up knowing, you know, that they can be artistic in other places, then, you know, it might help them out in the long run.
I think if you did, maybe not so much as a building, but if you did, like, art in the park. Mm-hmm. Kind of catchy. if you just had, like, exhibits in parks. Because, I mean, Greensboro is full of gorgeous parks and just flowers and everything like that, to where you could just have, like, you could just set up events, like, every weekend or something like that during the spring and summer.
I guess just reinforcement that when I go to the center, I'll be able to express myself creatively and artistically. So by going to the YMCA and the Boys and Girls Clubs and, you know, telling them about what they can do here and asking them what they want to do, and then just reassuring them that that can be done at your art center, then that's how you'll get more people to come.
A catchy jingle will always be great. I love jingles. I gotta say, I sing them all the time. I like billboards. I'm one of those weird people who reads, like, every billboard they come across. And the one thing I don't like is flyers. I hate people just passing out flyers to anybody who comes around.
Yeah.
But Facebook. I get Facebook invites and stuff all the time. So, that helps bring awareness with all the social networking sites and stuff. Probably just those three.
All right.
Gotta get that. Gotta get that. Gotta get that. Gotta get that. Yep, 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 yep. Boom, boom, boom. Gotta get that. 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 Boom, boom, boom. That boom, boom, boom. That boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom. Yo, I got that hit to beat the block. You can get that bass on below. I got that rock and roll. That future flow. That digital spit, next level visual. I got that boom, boom, boom. How to beat bang.
I like that boom, boom, pow. Them chickens jacking my style. They try to copy my swagger. I'm on that next now. I'm sold 3008. You sold 2000 and late. I got that boom, boom, boom. That future boom, boom, boom. Let me get it now.
Boom, boom, boom. Gotta get that. 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 Boom, that boom, boom, boom. That boom, boom, boom. That boom, boom, boom.
I'm on that supersonic.